The bus company at the centre of the crash was raided by police overnight and slapped with several infringement notices. It comes as shocking new video of a school bus full of kids speeding in the Central West raises serious safety concerns.
So now we're taking off again.
Running late for a swimming carnival.
We're 120 now.
The limit on the road into Coolah in the state Central West is 100.
Me.
This driver seemingly passing 130.
In the fog, mind you, we're doing 120 k's an hour. And there's little kids walking around in the bus.
It happened yesterday morning, the same day police raided operator Linq Busline. During the audit, 20 buses were inspected. 7 defect notices were issued, including 1 major defect for a cracked windscreen, oil leaks, inoperative seatbelts and vehicle lights, and insecure seats. As a result, the operator was issued 2 infringement notices. Linq says they've already rectified the major defect and are working to the timeline set for the others. Long before it's established what, if any, difference mandatory seatbelts might have made here on Sunday night, there have been calls to make them compulsory on all buses. The Premier, though, won't be making a quick decision.
It's not a decision I can make today. I will be listening to the report from New South Wales Police, their critical incident report. There'll be a coronial inquiry as well. Obviously, they are mandatory for regional school buses and coaches. I want to make sure we get it right, but any announcement that we make has to be practical and implemented quickly too.
Evan Batten, 7 News.